antimatter is the mirror image of ordinary matter. However, matter has one charge, and antimatter has the opposite charge. If there was an anti-me made out of antimatter, that person in principle could look exactly like me. Same personality quirks, same everything, except of course when I decide to shake his hand. At that point, we both would blow ourselves to smithereens in a gigantic nuclear explosion.
Matter with a positive charge clashes with antimatter with a negative charge. The fate of the universe hangs in the balance of this epic battle. Equal amounts of matter and antimatter will cancel each other out. And it's not good.
A universe with equal amounts of matter and antimatter is equivalent to a universe with no matter at all. Because the matter and antimatter will annihilate back into pure radiation. And there'll be nothing interesting, no stars and galaxies and people in between.
It was a cosmic battle. And the side with the most forces would win. It was very close, but there was one winner.
For every billion particles of antimatter, there were a billion and one particles of matter. That was the moment of creation. The one extra particle of matter in each little volume survives enough to form all the matter we see in the stars and galaxies today.
One in a billion might not sound like much, but it's enough to build a universe.
We're the leftovers. So believe it or not, everything you see around you, the atoms of your body, the atoms of the stars, are nothing but leftovers. Leftovers from this ancient collision between matter and antimatter.